Hey there, I hope you're well. It's Friday, which means it's time for Fast Key Fridays. Now, how would you like to add in video effects, audio effects, or transitions with just one key? Well, that's what today's video is all about. Hey there, I'm Mark Brown with Editor's Keys, and this is Fast Key Fridays. If you've never seen the series before, click up here to watch the entire series from the start, or I'll put the link in the description below. But this week's video is all about some lesser-known shortcuts that are really some of my favorites. They'll help you add transitions, video effects, and audio effects all in with a single key. So let's jump straight into it, and I'll show you how it's done. Now, I do love these shortcuts I'm about to show you. So first of all, let's say that you need to start adding some transitions to your project. Now, what you can do, if you have, say, this clip selected here, you can simply press Command and T, and that's gonna add a default transition. Now, in this case, this is the cross dissolve shortcut. But that's not really what I want to show you. Let's say you want to add a particular type of transition to every clip. Let's just delete this here. You can actually choose your own default transition. So let's press Control, Command, and 5 to bring up our transitions. And let's say, I'll tell you what, let's say you've just time traveled from 1990 and you want to make the page curl your default transition. All you need to do is right click on that transition and click Make Default. Now, I must say, if you are an editor, this will disqualify you as an editor, but anyway, I'm gonna make that the default transition. So now, if we press Command and T, you'll see that it now adds a page curl to every single clip that we do that on. Now, next up is the default color effect. Now, if you press Option and E, you'll see that this adds a color board. So you can get into editing your colors and your color correction, and you can do that. But again, you can choose a particular color. So if we, let's remove that. Let's bring up our effects by pressing Command and 5. And let's just say, for example, you've got a particular LUT or an effect that you want to put on to your video. So for this example, just so it's easy to see, I'm gonna add this comic look. Let's let it load up. And I'm gonna make that the default video effect. And you can do that by right-clicking here, click Make Default Video Effect. So, you know, if you're color correcting or you've got a particular look or style that you wanna add to every clip in your timeline or particular clips, you can now do that by simply pressing Option E. And then let's go along to this clip here, press Option E. And you'll see it now makes every clip in your timeline that video effect. Okay, so next up is audio, and there's also a default channel EQ shortcut. You can get to that by selecting an audio clip and pressing Command, Option, and E. And you'll see that loads up the effect here. Now, again, you can make this into any effect that you want. So one that I use constantly is the multi-band compressor. I'm just gonna go to all. And if we scroll down to the bottom here, I can now make that the default. So when I'm going through and I'm editing some voiceover or audio, I can just go into a clip here. Let's do that now. And I can press Command, Option, and E. And you'll see now at the bottom, we now have the multiband compressor added as our default audio effect. Pretty good, hey? There we go. So that's this week's shortcuts. And what do you think of those? I really love them because if you're working on a project which has similar transitions or effects that you need to add in, it's just a super simple way to get that done super quick. So let me know what you thought of those shortcuts. I'd love to hear from you. And are you going to start using those too? Now, if you want to see next week's episode, it's a good one next week, so make sure you hit that subscribe button. And if you want to check out our keyboard selection as well that you saw in the video, I'll put a link in the description for those too. But anyway, I'll see you next Friday.